Welcome. Meet Triggers, our new reply feature. Triggers allow you to automate your routine actions and save time. Once you set up your triggers and a trigger event happens in reply, the corresponding action will be performed automatically based on your specified requirements. You can assign a newly created contact to the specific owner, for example, based on the company's size or location. You can add a newly created contact to a specific list based on any contact field, or remove a contact from the sequence if they responded, bounced, or opted out. You can mark the contact as finished once a call is logged, and a lot more. You can also make your sequences conditional. For example, once a contact clicks a link or opens an email a certain number of times, you can have the contact move to a specific step in a sequence. To create a trigger, log into your reply account, navigate to the settings page, triggers tab, and click the plus button in the upper right corner. For example, let's create a trigger that moves the contacts that have opened your email 3 times to an SMS step of your sequence. To do this, on the new trigger page, enter a name for the trigger and select your trigger from the dropdown. Then, set your conditions by clicking the Add Condition button for each new condition in the Condition section. In Team Edition Public, when a team member creates a trigger, it works for the whole team. For example, you can create a trigger that will apply to all sequences of all the team members. But if you need something specific, you have to set up filters, like country, contact owner, or sequence owner. For example, you can create a trigger with a filter for a contact owner to move contacts to a sequence only when the contact owner is Maria. Triggers are available in beta. If you have any questions about this feature, reach out to our support team at support@reply.io.